It's out of memory, the Lord of Blood. Draw on enemies without summoning cursed blood, causing summoned spirits to sail them with a rabid fervor. In old times of old, the dead were burned with ghost flame, and from those cinders rose vengeful spirits. So, would you combo a Rancor pot and a cursed blood pot? Or do summoned spirits mean the ashes? Create a red shadow. High effective against those who live in death, even preventing them from rising again. The Golden Order has no mercy for those who trespass beyond life's bounds. Actually, as someone was saying that if you, in like Dark Souls 1, if you use a particular spell, the guidance, you would actually be able to find the developer commentary. Which is nice. I'm not sure if that's true, but... I noticed, yeah. The developer... We be Ash Lake now. But, I'm not sure if that's true, but I would be interested in finding out. Because it would be cool to see, read developer commentary. A good dark, therefore precious item. It was weird how the spell, there's stuff in Dark Souls 1 that did, like Abyss Sorceries, they did physical damage, but Dark just gets introduced as an element in the future games. But then again, I suppose the Abyss Sorceries didn't cross over. They were remade as hexes and whatnot. Different types of magic. It wasn't an Abyss Sorcery. So, less pure, more magic. Less of a connection with humanity to it. I guess. It's kind of been bugging me since Dark Souls 2. I thought you were going to be Toki-Toki. They seem different. Wish I knew how much I was getting back. Ancestral infant's head. Skull of a very young ancestral spirit. Just think how many sproutlings it might bear. The eye in it is capitalized. Use FP to spray spirit vapor, inflicting magic damage. The vapor becomes a temporary geyser, which uses continuous damage shifting it touches until it disappears. There, just above the head. I was wondering what the hell it was. Okay. I'm not looking forward to this. I think that's the Castellan's gear. Jaren. Yeah, that's the Crucible Knight. Or at least his gear. Sophria, Aqueduct. I'm not sure if the scab shed actually comes in here. A bit over you. Interesting design under shields. It's like veins. Got a bit over eager. To get a backstab off on him. It would make combat a lot easier if it had a lot less health. Oh, it didn't go true. Then I remember having that issue before. Never remembering how to quite, use the other ammo type. I see how there's two down there. I could never remember how to use the other arrow type. Just had to check my chair. Felt low, that it lowered itself. Move. I'm gonna try. I'm not sure if you could hear that. I could certainly feel it. Pop my shoulder. Or crack my shoulder more so. I feel beat up. That did not work as expected. They're very short-lived, relatively worthless. Mystery's cookbook, golden centipedes. Don't they only appear in holy places? Damn it. Okay, I'm gonna go somewhere else. I'm gonna have to fight these guys. I'm not ready for them. Or maybe I need to change my equipment. Hmm. I'm gonna look up exactly what Axe Talisman works on. Charge attacks are performed by holding the strong attack input until the attack is unleashed. Dark Moon Greatsword. A Moon Greatsword bestowed by a carrying queen upon her spouse to honor long-standing tradition. One of the legendary armaments. Randy's sigil is a full moon, cold and leaden, and the sword is but a beam of its light. Okay, this has been actually entirely worthless to me. I apparently haven't been using it right at all. Oh damn, that increases health by a huge chunk. Over 100 hit points, but also increases damage taken, which will not help me. Okay. So, strong attack. That's a strong attack. That's a fully charged. Meanwhile. So yeah, there's a difference. I think I may ignore those souls. Fucking bridge is broke. I'm gonna try this again. Die easy, so damn it. Ah. He tracks you. Down. Okay, never did get to see that on Crucible Night. Eat shit and die, asshole. Crucible horn shield. Great shield of red tinged gold carried by crucible knights. Features a great horn. An ancient holiness dwells within. The crucible horn skewers foes when performing shield bashes. Huh. What did the messengers from Bloodborne look like? Because these are kind of making me think of larger, petrified versions of them. Like, I've seen little bits of Bloodborne. I've never played it. Never watched a Let's Play either. Oh, and, this place does have a gothic feel to it, doesn't it? Like, I love Bloodborne, but, Sony owns it. Same reason I haven't touched, Demon's Souls. Sony holds the rights to it. I'd love to have the kind of money where I could just buy it off them and then just give it to FromSoft, if only so I could record them. It's another Crucible Knight. Mage this time. Why couldn't I do a back attack there? No, it's a mace. Oh god. He's got an ally. It's only a slave, but still. These guys are tough enough without them getting a little bit of extra damage run around. Christ, what sound are you making? Goddamn that range. You've got antlers coming out too. Oh, fuck off. Drill to pierce the heavens, baby. Jesus Christ. Yeah, they've got horns growing too. Wonder if they're ancestral followers, or is this due to their dragon devotion? Yeah, that guy ain't coming back. I can't get back attacks off on these guys. They're immune to them, it seems. But I can at the very least do a style. And that's a quarter of his health bar gone. Do it again. Eat shit. Shame, they're buddies. Somber smitting stone tree. You know, I could never pull off a fully charged tank. Like, that's just... But... Spirit Flame Arrow. Oh, it's what the corpses used to be burnt with. It's all coming together. Thankfully, unlike, say, the crystal lizards, these can't disappear while running. Order healing. They can't disappear while running. They have to stop. And you hit them, it gives you more time. Which, admittedly, I think crystal lizards also have to abide by, but... they can just disappear while running away from you. They have to stop. One of the incantations of the Golden Order Fundamentalists, used by hunters of those who live in death, alleviates death blight buildup. The Noble Gold Mask lamented what had become of the hunters, how easy it is for learning and learnedness to be reduced to ravings fanatics. All the good and the great wanted, in their foolishness, was an absolute evil to contend with. Does such a notion exist in the fundamentals of order? Yeah, that's a folly people IRL fall into quite easily. It's mine. If you do have like some like crusade, we'll speak be flippant of it. You gotta be careful of not, what was the phrasing of it? Gotta be wary of inventing an absolute evil to contend with. See, too many people forget that someone may disagree with you on a point, but that doesn't make them a demon, a devil. Some absolute, you know, like some devil figure. They're still a person. And they may disagree with you on this one point, but otherwise, they're identical to you. So. One, two. Trying to make a point there, but well, it wasn't wrong. I'm not just happy with it. But yeah, people fall into a similar issue IRL. It's something you always got to watch yourself for. Just seeing, like, someone, like, a political rival, or, well, not a political rival, but someone may disagree with you on a point, and it's far too easy to fall into seeing them as El Diablo, you know? Or, you know, like, your goals are met, but if the goals are met, you have nothing left to fight. So, you know, you keep looking for something to fight. Maybe it's a bit different from what they're saying there, but it's still something to watch yourself for, you know? Inner order. Oh, are you Gold Mask? Just order. Yeah. With leg movement, and it could have been one of the Buddhist candies from Sekiro. The stances you do thereafter. Okay. Time to get there. Okay, we'll give this a shot. Group ahead. But Valiant Gargoyle? Not Sekiro, damn it. It just reminded me of a wind cutter move that the sword saint did. Stuck in the slagmites. Valiant Gargoyle, Twin Blade. Oh, fantastic. Multi fucking bosses. Imagine the other one joining. It's a health thing. I was trying to roll there. I hear it. Here comes the second. Alright, I'm gonna leave that there for now and go poke somewhere else. Okay, I'm gonna look it up. Elden Ring Rune Farm. PC Gamer. Okay, Gold Scarab. Okay. Okay, there's the abandoned cave in Kaid. I need to go there. Okay, they actually do recommend using the remember the guys from before? Remember the militia guys? We're actually gonna go get that rune. Go get that item. Here? So if I go south from here, I should find it. But, you know, they actually do recommend those militia guys I stumbled onto before. They're like first on the list. I could go back there after getting the scarab. That's the gold serpent ring of the game. I could go back there after getting that. As it is a good one. I could switch my gear to a different weapon, because I am using a sword against statues. I'm not a fan of fighting this tank, but I'm going to do so. Well, that was a misclick. I could go back up there. I've just killed him a fair chunk already, so I'm a little... Come on. He roared, interrupting, got attack, and got the final hit. Of course. I hate fighting these bears. They're too fast, too strong, and too high health. They're very aggravating enemies to go up to fight against. No, I think it's just they're very aggressive and they hit very hard. You don't really get much breathing space. And it's very easy to get into a loop of just die, heal, die. Well, hit, heal, hit, heal, hit, heal, till you run out of flasks. Remember I was saying there was an accusation of the game having, input reading? Yeah, it was off this enemy. Maybe I'm just being a sore loser right now, I'm not sure. And I'm dead. Yeah, rawr. They're the most aggravating enemy I think I've fought in the Soulsborne. Yeah, I feel like they're the most aggravating enemy I've fought in the Soulsborne. Nice. Fine, we'll go this way. But yeah, they're really fast, they're strong. They got very extensive combos. It's not like they just do a swing and back to guard stance. They do multiple attacks. They're very aggravating, and I hope I never find one as a boss. They're enough of a roaming boss as it is. Maybe better with a faster weapon here. I'm impatient as shit. And I can't ride around after this one. Gotcha. Poison armament. First time I've found a joint one. Well, I saw this ages back, but I've only ever seen one that size before. Hmm. Hmm.